Sometimes in art, one has to make the ultimate sacrifice. Sacrificium is the title of a new album of opera arias by the Italian mezzo-soprano Cecilia Bartoli. She joins us now from the studios of the Swiss Broadcasting Corporation in Zurich. Ms. Bartoli, thanks so much for being with us.
Hello. Oh, thank you. Thank you. It's my pleasure.
And we'll say this very carefully. This is an album of music written for castrati, young men whose manhood was maimed so their singing voices wouldn't break.
Yeah, castrati were the singers, the pop singers of 18th century. And most of this music is part of the school, the Napoletanish school, you know. And just to give you an example, the one of the greatest castrato of the Napoletanish school was Farinelli. And the teacher of Farinelli was Porpora, Nicola Porpora. And in this project, we have a lot of music composed by Porpora himself, yes.
I certainly don't mind telling you, and it's, I think, clear from the liner notes that you yourself think, in the 21st century, this is a pretty twisted idea. Who said, I know, we need a high singing voice, this is what we'll do? How did this come about?
Well, this is a story about, as you mentioned, sacrificium of thousands of boys. So the sacrifice of hundreds of thousands of boys in the name of music. But in fact, most of these boys were coming from very poor family of the south of Italy, you know, with 10, 12 children. One child was sacrificed on the name of music because they were hoping that these boys were making a career and save the family from the poverty, you know, because as I said before, so being a Caffarelli or Farinelli was like being a pop star, was like being Michael Jackson, you know what I mean? Yeah. This is really was a big business in 18th century. But of course, it probably is the most cruel story in the history of music.
Let's hear some of the music because it is hauntingly beautiful.
Yes.
Of course, that's not castrati, castrato singing now.
No, it's a good point. No, it's not a castrato. It's me, and I'm not a castrato. I'm a mezzo, lyric mezzo, high mezzo, but with a big passion for Baroque music and from... It's fun. And especially for Porpora. So this was a music composed by Porpora. Beautiful aria, parto, ti lascio cara. And the opera is Germanico in Germania.
If we could hear kind of another dimension of the music, that was hauntingly beautiful. This is kind of fast and furious. Nobody else in the world arguably sings like you, but is this more difficult to sing than other pieces anyway?
Well, this is, it's difficult, but it's clear that if you want to perform this music, you need a lot of breath control. And this was an aria composed by Francesco Araya, which is not really a well-known composer, but he composed this piece, and the aria is Cadrò ma qual si mira. So castrati were men singing with a female voice, but the body was a body of a man. And this is, I think, is the challenge, I mean, for a woman to perform this repertoire, because, of course, we cannot really compare the capacity of oxygen in a lung, you know, than a woman has compared to a man. So breath control is extremely important.
What fascinated you about the music? The music, the story, all of it?
From one side, you have the most beautiful, probably, music composed in the 18th century. And from the other side, you have the most cruel story of 18th century. So this is, I think, this cruelty and beauty and cruelty in one project. You know, this is, I think it's extremely fascinating, yes. And it's a big discovering also, because most of this music never been recorded before.
I want to listen here, if we could, some more music. This, this again, Nicola Porpora. Startling piece here. Imitating a nightingale?
Yes, so, kind of nightingale, you're right. Every good castrato had to sing, or at least every good castrato was asking a composer to compose an aria, a nightingale arias, yes. And the voice of a castrato, they really had an amazing technique also, so they had a possibility to sing in the very low register to the very high register, and with an extremely flexibility in the voice, and they, of course, they had to also imitate all the beautiful instrument we have in nature, and birds, and other instruments too. Yeah,
you know, obviously, what happened to castrati was cruel and indefensible, but I guess I don't want us to lose sight of the fact that they really were celebrated personages, weren't they? As you say, the rock stars of their day.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. So the one who they had the possibility to make a career, they really had an amazing life. I mean, they really were pop stars. So, but the name Sacrificium, so the title of this recording, is in order to remember the one, the castrati, they had no possibility to make a career, which were the majority, you know, because in Italy they were castrating between 3,000 and 4,000 boys every year, and only one or two of them, they really had the big career, you know. In fact, the one that they had the possibility to make a career, at least they had the satisfaction of success, of money, and things like that. But, of course, they also, even themselves, they had a very difficult life, you know, because to be a castrato, so they were in one way loved by the society, and in the other way they were rejected because they were no men, no women. So it's really, really a tragic story. One, as I said before, glorious, you know, the tragedy and the glory, you know.
Ms. Bartoli, thanks so much. Very good talking to you.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
Cecilia Bartoli's new release is called Sacrificium, and you can see photos of Cecilia Bartoli and hear the new CD in its entirety, what a bargain, on our website, nprmusic.org. This is Weekend Edition from NPR News. I'm Scott Simon.